All right, Gucci Maniacs, I am back. This is the 400th, as I promised, call-out video. Before I get started, I want to give out a couple of shout-outs to some Gucci Maniacs that have been here or who have been part of this channel for a very long time. We'll start with Miss D. Stinson, a.k.a. Joe Carr, on Facebook. Because if it wasn't for her, the Gooch call-out videos, this channel, everything I do would not be. Going on, because she set up the account for me. She helped me get the YouTube channel going. So, give her a shout out. I want to give a shout out to the Bell family. You've seen them in 100, 200, and 300. They've been following me since day one, almost. Another person who I want to give a shout out is Big John Ward back in Madison Heights, Virginia. Has been following me since day one. I've been working on a lot of new stuff for y'all. Now, I want to thank all 361 of y'all that are following me here. If you're following me here, go to Rumble and follow me over there. Follow me on Facebook. On Rumble, I go by the Gooch 72. This is my channel over there. That's where a lot of my videos the last 2 years have been, since they haven't been allowing me to do videos on here. And ladies and gentlemen, and boys and girls, if you're watching this, because 98% of the people who watch my videos are not subscribed, please subscribe here and on Rumble. Also, if you watch any of my videos on Rumble, if they got a commercial on them, watch the commercial all the way through so I can get paid. I get paid 15 cents every time you watch one of those commercials all the way through on my videos on Rumble. Now, with that said, let's get into today's video. Today's video is somebody I'm not calling out, not because I don't like their politics, not because I don't like their form of entertainment or anything like that. I'm calling this individual up because I'm tired of hearing them over the radio. I'm tired of seeing them in commercials, and I'm tired of seeing them when I watch football. That's why I don't watch football anyway. This one might get me in some trouble with some people, but I don't care, because I'm the man, the myth, the legend, the Gooch. Tonight, the Gooch is calling out Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift. First of all, you expect me to take political advice from you? How can I take political advice or support somebody you support politically when you write music and songs about your poor choice in men? And, of course, everybody's making a big deal about you dating this Travis Kelce that plays for the Chiefs. Let's be honest. We know the whole entire team is running drills on you every night, because we know football players love sharing their women, and the ones that don't, kill them. Just ask O.J. Simpson. Now that I got those jokes out of the way, first of all, Taylor, I don't like your political views. I never will like your political views. You shouldn't even try to influence your fan base to vote the way you vote. A lot of celebrities think it's wrong to do that. And the most important, the greatest celebrity, the greatest musician of all times, the greatest entertainer of all times, the king of rock and roll, the king of all music himself, Elvis, thought that celebrities should stay out of politics and stick to entertainment, and Elvis is right. Because Elvis, just like me, and just like the late Rush Limbaugh and the late Dr. Jerry Falwell, is always right. Woo! But anyway. Second of all, a lot of your music don't make sense. There was one song that plays over the intercom where I work all the time. Your friends talk to my friends talk to me. We're never, ever, ever getting back together. I mean, okay, unless that was written about your high school boyfriend, every single girl I've ever dated, and I've dated quite a few, not a single one of their friends know my friends. I guarantee you, I can go up to my four closest friends in Virginia and ask them to name one friend of one of my old girlfriend's friend, you know, one of my old girlfriend's friends' name, and they can't do it. Because if that was written about a boyfriend that's not in high school, there's no way his friends would be hanging out with your friends unless you and him are hanging out with them too. It doesn't make sense. It's a stupid song. Then again, all your songs are stupid. But then again, what do you expect when you're a woman and women aren't very bright? And those of you who might get offended by that, that's a joke. Because some feminists will get offended by jokes like that. You're not supposed to tell jokes like that anymore. But I don't care. Just read my shirt. Anyway, you're dating Trevor Kelsey, and I made the statement that if you really cared about Travis Kelsey, and if you really cared about his fans and not just yourself and your fans, then you would sit down on the field with the other players' wives. Don't give me that bull crap about, well, she's a celebrity and it's a security thing. She has no right to fly around on her own jet. If she's dating an athlete, she should travel with the other players' wives like they do in all the other sports. Sit down on the field with all the other wives. And don't give me that crap about she's a celebrity, because I am going to debunk that part. Trust me, I'm going to debunk that soon. That's coming up later on in this video. Trust me. Because I have some examples. Because Taylor Swift's not the first woman. I had to be careful. I wanted to say something else. To date or marry a professional athlete. So I'm going to get there soon. Very soon. But anyway. The camera should not be on you half as much as should be on the action on the field. Because these other women I'm naming that I want to talk about, when the few times the camera is put on them during the games, they sit there like a normal human being watching the game. Yeah, they might clap or cheer their husbands on or their boyfriends on, or whatever they are to them. Or they'll just sit there and be having a conversation with one of the other players' wives like a normal human being and not reacting for the cameras like you do, you stupid fake woman. Now, there's a woman I work with who I never agree with until she said this, that you're the most fake person in the world. And she's absolutely right. You're fake. Everything about you is fake. Your talent isn't all that great. You're not that great of a singer. You're not all that good looking. You were at one point. But you're not now, because you sold your soul to Hollywood to be Elzebub. Now, here's some examples of other women who are famous, and some of them more famous than you, were married to athletes or dating athletes, sat down on the field, traveled with other players' wives, didn't act like an idiot when the cameras put on them. I want to start with an athlete I absolutely cannot stand. A guy who, even if he wasn't a steroid user in baseball, I would still not like this guy because he's an arrogant jerk. And that's Alex Rodriguez. Alex Rodriguez has dated Jennifer Lopez. Jennifer Lopez sat down on the field with the wives, traveled with the team wives, didn't act like an idiot when the cameras put on her during the time she dated Steel Rod Rodriguez. Jennifer Hudson, who was married to Steel Rod, same thing. Traveled with the other wives, sat with the other wives, and didn't act like an idiot when the camera was put on her. Now let's go to the next wife slash girlfriend of somebody who's dated or married a professional athlete. And that's somebody whose husband is currently playing for the Houston Astros. And that's Jennifer. I can't think of her last name right now, but her first name was Jennifer. She's married to Justin Verlander. But, no, not Jennifer. Kate Upton. Kate Upton. That's her name. Kate Upton. Kate Upton is married to Jason Verlander. And Kate Upton travels with the other team's wives. She sits with the other team's wives on the field. She doesn't act like an idiot when the camera's put on her. I don't agree with her politics either, but I respect the fact that she acts like a normal human being. She sits there with other teams' wives. She respects her husband's fans. If somebody comes up and asks her for an autograph during the game, and I've seen this on camera a couple times, she signs stuff. So I applaud Kate Upton for doing that. And here's the biggest example. Someone who's a far bigger star than you, Taylor, was far more bigger than you, legendary, someone who will be remembered long after you're gone, even though they're no longer here. And they were married to one of the ugliest baseball players in all of baseball. She was married to Joe DiMaggio. Of course, she died before I was born, but anyway. Marilyn Monroe is a prime example of a woman who traveled with the team or traveled with the other team's wives, sat with the other team's wives, didn't act like an idiot when the camera was put on her, unless she was being paid. Unless you're being paid, yeah, it's fine to act the way you do during those games, Taylor. But you're an idiot. You suck. Your fans suck. Your fans are probably a bunch of whores anyway. Little skanks. So the Gooch is calling you out for being a very fake person, for being an awful person. And by the way, Taylor, don't hate the Gooch because he's sexier than you. Hate the Gooch because he's better than you. And that's the bottom line, because the Gooch said so. Woo!